Yes. The other day we completed the Be Reading discussion. Every success story is also a story of great failures. Now we are going to discuss comprehension in this. There are some three questions given there. First question, to Lincoln, defeat was a detour and not a dead end. Justify this statement from the life of Lincoln. When we were discussing the lesson, this was clearly discussed. I think you remember, children. To Lincoln, defeat was a detour. What is the meaning of a detour? That the road or route we take, that is you, when the usual one is closed. So defeat was a detour for Lincoln, not a dead end. Dead end means what? Beyond that you cannot progress. So you have to justify this statement from the life of Lincoln. Now you see, several times he failed in his life, but he never gave up because he did not consider defeat or failure as a dead end. He considered it as a detour, a chance for him to take another route to reach his destination. For example, see, he failed in the business at the age of 21. He was defeated in a legislative race at the age 22. And he failed again in business at age 24. He overcame the death of his sweetheart at age 26. He had a nervous breakdown at age 27. He lost a congressional race at age 34. He lost a senatorial race at age 45. Failed in an effort to become vice president at age 47. Lost a senatorial race at age 49. And finally was elected president of the United States at age 52. From this we can understand, to Lincoln, defeat was a detour, not a dead end. We can justify this statement from the life of Lincoln like that. Several times he failed. In business he failed. In politics he failed. He lost his sweetheart and he had a nervous breakdown. In spite of all these, he had become the President of the United States of America at age 52. That is what, how we can justify that particular statement. Second question, what did Socrates suggest as the secret to success? Do you agree or disagree with him? Give reasons for your answer. You remember, a young man asked Socrates the secret to success. And Socrates suggested a burning desire. What is the secret to success according to Socrates? When we want, if anybody is drowning in water, at that time, that particular person wants air. So if everybody wants success as badly as one wants air when they are underwater, that is the secret to success. There is no other secret. So he is asking another question. Do you agree or disagree with him? Of course, everybody has to agree with that statement. Without a burning desire to achieve a purpose or achieve a goal, what's the meaning of searching for the secret to success? There is nothing that you can buy from a shop, from a market, the secret that can take you to success. So if you want to achieve, you have to go on working hard till you reach that one. You may fail several times. Success and failure are the two sides of the same coin. Sometimes we may succeed, sometimes we may fail. That doesn't mean, when we fail, that doesn't mean that we have to end our lives there itself. That should not be a dead end. Like that, you have to give reasons for your answer, if you agree or disagree. Now there is a table given there. Complete the following table about the failures and successes of the great personalities mentioned in the lesson you have just read. The first one is done for you. See, we have talked about 9 people here in this lesson. Abraham Lincoln, first person we talked about, failed in business, means we have tried the failures or rejections he faced in the middle column. Finally, how, what the success that they had achieved, these individuals, we have tried in the last column. In the first column, we are writing about the person, the name of the person there. He failed in business, defeated in legislative elections, had nervous breakdown, lost the congressional race and senatorial race. Final success, elected President of the United States of America. Next, invented the triode tube. Who is that person who invented the triode tube? Lee D. Forrest. What are the failures that he faced or rejections he faced? He was charged by the district attorney for cheating the people, for using fraudulent means to mislead the public into buying stocks of his company, and he was publicly humiliated. These are the failures or rejections he faced. But finally, what did he do? He invented the triode tube. Wright brothers. What was the failure or rejection he faced? A New York Times editorial, I think you remember, made fun of the Wright brothers when they announced that they were going to invent a machine heavier than air that could fly. But finally, on December 3, 1903, they invented the aeroplane. They flew their first flight. They took their first flight at Kitty Hawk. Next, fourth number person. Knocked many doors before he got the first order. Who is that? Colonel Sanders. He had his mother's recipe of cooking a chicken with him, and he knocked many doors before he got the first order. He might have knocked around 1,000 doors. Finally, he got his first order. What is that final success? He became the founder of KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken chain of hotels. Walt Disney, what were his failures or rejections? He was told that he had no talent by many editors of the newspapers. A final success? Creation of Mickey Mouse, the most popular cartoon character. Next, grew up to be a great scientist. Who is that grew up to be a great scientist? Thomas Edison. His teacher sent a note to his mother saying that he was stupid to learn. He did not have formal schooling for more than 3 months. But he finally grew up to be a great scientist. He became the inventor of the electric bulb. Then established cars company. Who is that? Henry Ford. Henry Ford failed to put a reverse gear in the first car that he had made. But he established a cars company. Lee Iacocca were fired by Henry Ford at the age of 54. But finally, he succeeded in making the most popular brands of Ford cars, Ford Mustang and Ford Pinto. And he became the chairman of Chrysler Corporation. Last one, gave some of the best music to the world, young Beethoven. And young Beethoven was told that he had no talent for music. That was what he was told, but he gave some of the best music to the world. Okay, with that we come to the end of comprehension. Now let us go to study skills. What do you mean by study skills? You have to understand. Study means read something seriously, understand the content properly, and then develop your own ideas to write a conclusion, to give a different conclusion to a story, to give an appropriate title to the story. So everybody must develop these study skills. For that purpose only, in every unit you are given study skills exercise. In as a part of study skills in this particular unit, there is a story given. Listen to the story carefully, children. An elderly carpenter was ready to retire. He told his employer contractor of his plans to leave the house building business to live a more leisurely life with his wife and enjoy his extended family. He would miss the paycheck each week, but he wanted to retire. They could get by. The contractor was sorry to see his good worker go and asked if he could build just one more house as a personal favor. The carpenter agreed, but over time it was easy to see that his heart was not in his work. He resorted to shoddy workmanship and used inferior materials. It was an unfortunate way to end a dedicated career. When the carpenter finished his work, his employer came to inspect the house. Then he handed the front door key to the carpenter and said, "This is your house, my gift to you." The carpenter was shocked. What a shame! If he had only known that he was building his own house, he would have done it also differently. So it is with us. We build our lives a day at a time, often putting less than our best into the building. Then, with a shock, we realize we have to live in the house we have built. If we could do it over, we would do it much differently. But you cannot go back. You are the carpenter, and every day you hammer a nail, place a board, or erect a wall. Someone once said, life is a do-it-yourself project. Your attitude and the choices you make today help build the house you will live in tomorrow. Therefore, build wisely. I think you have understood the story. Once you read two or three times, you should understand. This is not something that we should explain, because it is you only who have to develop these study skills. After reading it two or three times, complete the table given below. See that. First, serial number one, point to be observed. The setting or location in which the story took place. And you have to write evidence from the story. Second, the main characters. Write in the next column. What are the main events? There are five main events. They're given there, five blanks. You have to write those events. The turning point in the story means the particular point of the story which suddenly takes a turn. The irony in the story, the message in the story, suggest a possible title. These are all the things that we have to do, children. And the second question in this is, rewrite the above story by giving another ending of your own. Suppose you are asked to give a separate or completely different ending to the same story. What ending you want to write? You just think and write a separate ending for it, a different ending for the story. Okay, children, this is all about study skills. Let us go to listening now. Just you listen to this passage, and then we have to answer the questions given here. In the listening passage, it's only meant for listening, nothing more than that. Attitude is everything. The title of this listening passage is Attitude is Everything. There was a farmer in Africa who was happy and content. He was happy because he was content. He was content because he was happy. One day, a wise man came to him and told him about the glory of diamonds and the power that goes along with them. The wise man said, "If you had a diamond the size of your thumb, you could have your own city. If you had a diamond the size of your fist, you could probably own your own country." And then he went away. Then that night, the farmer couldn't sleep. He was unhappy and he was discontent. He was unhappy because he was discontent, and discontent because he was unhappy. The next morning, he made arrangements to sell off his farm, took care of his family, and went in search of diamonds. He looked all over Africa and couldn't find any. He looked all through Europe and couldn't find any. When he got to Spain, He was so emotionally, physically and financially broke. He got so disheartened that he threw himself into the Barcelona River and committed suicide. Back home, the person who had bought his farm was watering the camels at a stream that ran through the farm. Across the stream, the rays of the morning sun hit a stone and made it sparkle like a rainbow. He thought it would look good on the mantelpiece. He picked up the stone and put it in the living room. That afternoon, the wise man came and saw the stone sparkling. He asked, "Is Hafiz back?" The new owner said, "No." "Why do you ask?" The wise man said, "Because that is diamond. I recognize one when I see one." The man said, "No, that is just a stone I picked up from the stream. Come, I will show you. There are many more." They went and picked some samples and sent them for analysis. Sure enough, the stones were diamonds. They found that the farm was indeed covered with acres and acres of diamonds. This is the listening passage given for you, exclusively for you to listen, understand and answer the comprehension given there. Just now you have listened to the story about a farmer. Here are some sentences that describe the events in the story. However, they are not in the order in which they occur in the story. Listen to the story and arrange them in the order in which they occur. Put one after the event that occurs first, two against the next, and so on. There are some sentences given, children. In this, all these sentences are not in proper order. You have to arrange these sentences in the order of occurrence of the particular events there in the story. This you have just listened to. And then write one against the first happening or first incident, then two for the next one, and so on like that. He threw himself into the Barcelona River and committed suicide. The wise man said, "Because that is a diamond." He picked up the stone and put it in the living room. He looked all through Europe and couldn't find any. They found that the farm was indeed covered with acres and acres of diamonds. That night, the farmer couldn't sleep. The person who had bought his farm was watering the camels at a stream. He made arrangements to sell off his farm and went in search of diamonds. He was unhappy and he was discontent. A wise man told him about the glory of diamonds. So all these sentences you have to arrange in a proper order. Chronological order, we say, according to which theory we write the incidents as they happen there in the story in a serial order. Okay, children, I think you can do that. There is an oral activity here. You have listened to the story. Now walk in pace and discuss the advantages and disadvantages of traveling abroad. You may use the hints given in the box for your understanding. So this is a pair work. You have to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of traveling abroad. And of course, there are some hints given there. Advantages: earn more money, social status, more opportunities. What are the disadvantages of going abroad? Cut off from your roots, living away from parents, brain drain and intellectual loss. Stop it. We'll take up this C reading in the next class, children. Thank you.